Welcome everybody.
This is Josefina Arbúdez.
And this is Fabián Peralta.
And we are in Días de Tango online edition.
Welcome everybody. So as I said, so pity we cannot meet each other, but fortunately we have the technology in these days to keep learning.
Yeah, we are super happy to be close to you, to go to your house, to your place. Stay safe, stay at home. And we are sure that we will see and we will hug again very, very soon. And we need to have our best version, right? So we will develop in this lesson in three different parts. First part will be tango, second part will be milonga, and the third part
is gonna be vals.
So let's start with the first one.
Yeah, we will do a tango figure. The models, as you know, we always do one figure, but not just. So you don't learn just the figure, but also the technique inside of the figure. So we will show you the full figure. After we will use it, some exercise. We will learn some exercise to improve the special technique movements you have inside of the figure. Okay, so let's do it. So this figure is from the great Carlo Mosciallo and Nati, which was his wife.
Yeah. So we will go for a few exercises. As Fabi said, they are useful for this figure, but not also for the whole tango, your technique, see?
Yeah. So we will start with the
enrosques.
Enrosques, okay? So normally, yes. If you're advanced or professional and you're watching this video, probably you know what enrosque is. Enrosque is the fact to torque something. Let's say you have a piece of fabric, and when you squeeze and torque, that is going to make enrosque. Also the screw, and when you do with the screw this action, you're enroscando. So the enrosque itself is the fact that you do this action with your body, when you cross your backward leg
behind the
base leg, and you do a rotation, okay? And you pivot your boss. This is enrosque.
Wow.
Mm-hmm, exactly.
It's not also for leaders, no? It's a movement that is very nice, useful for the ladies.
Yeah. So, how we normally do the enrosque? Well, normally we do, let's say, just as a model, we start from here, we can start from here or from another sagada, we'll show you later. So, normally we let go the lady, and see, I haven't done any pivot yet. And at the end, we whip with the hip to arrive on time of her backward step. Okay, in this case, in this sample model of enrosque. But these guys, Carlo Mosciallo and Nati, use a different way to do enrosque and planeos and so on.
And where is the difference?
That's a good question, Josefina. Thank
where
you so
is
much.
The difference?
Okay, the difference is coming from the moment that the Carlo Mosciallo have started the pivot. So as I show you with Josefina, I was let her go.
So on the side, backward side. Forward, and he didn't pivot yet.
And I pivot?
In this one. Yes. After the forward, to the side step for the lady.
But in this case, Carlo Mosciallo do something that we call enrosque planeado. And he start pivoting at the moment that she transferred the weight after the backward step in this example. So, here. So you see, we show you now the difference move between one and another. So normal enrosque, as we know, pam, 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 boom, how we do. In this case, Mosano and Nati. Eh? Such a nice, no?
Yeah. It's quite harder than the other, right? Because the first one is have more the natural impulse of the lady. It's like he just released when he cannot handle anymore the torsion. Instead of this one, he need to manage by its own the pivot and use the force of his body to pivot.
So let's say we will do some example to improve this kind of enrosque. And how you will do it. And so you will use whether the pivot of the lady, the first pivot of the lady that's a bird in her hero, respect the enrosque you and the moment that you start, or even the weight transfer, the first weight transfer of the lady after one step. Let's say she's here, you will take this moment. Instead of this moment. Yeah. Okay, but let's say that she's in front, and you are starting the enrosque in the front step of her. You will not wait for it here, here, and here, but you will do, you will release your pivot
here. At the moment that she moved for the next moment of the step, no?
Yeah. So we will do the three possible enrosque we have. In the front saccade, with the right foot, for example. So normally we wait, and release here.
Release with this pivot. Same?
And we will do. Boom. Already when she transferred the way. Boom. Boom. Okay?
Can show both?
Yes.
So first option, more delay. And what we are talking about now is this one.
Hmm? It's smoother. Let's go for the another moment of enrosque that you can find in the heel. When she go side, you can do enrosque also from here. So in this case, I will do my pivot at the moment that she trumpets away. Boom. Hmm? And this is how it should be, this type of enrosque. We do the two difference. So the normal one that we do, we wait. Boom. Mm-hmm. And the one that we're proposing, let's do with the other front. I get dizzy. Two, boom. As a sheet trumpet away.
Yeah.
And the last one, we already did two already, but when the lady does this backward step. So we will not wait, but as she transferred away, I release my video. Okay? So I get the, I think they got the idea of this.
Yes, we, since it's an online lesson, we beg you to put pause, and try to practice this by separate, because it will be very useful to know this kind of, this different way to do the enrosques. See?
Yes, so once you get this, we will go for the element you will find in the figure, which is a types of planeos and enrosque. You will find the first one in the Americana. So normally after Americana we will do this action. Pam, pam, boom, and go. That's what we normally do. But in this case you will start pivot even when she starts pivot. So pivot and change the way. Hmm? So the two difference. Why are we explaining this? Because we have teach this figure, and it always appears the same issue, let's say. People behave as they normally behave, let's say, no? So, because normally we go here, we turn the weight, and we pivot here. Eh? And in this case, I will start pivot in my right. I will not change my weight.
When I transfer.
And change my weight when she finishes the pivot. To my left to go up. So this is the first element we will found in the so a little front. So pam, pivot, change and go. This is the first enrosque movement. Afterwards, you will find another one which is as she's coming forward, basing on the left leg, you will be what? In the backward leg. And this is the other element, pivot you will find in the Natosca. So we recommend you to practice for separate. Once again, so she will come forward to my left. Pivot.
So he's pivoting in the backward leg, right?
In the left leg in this case. The other one, okay, it's at the moment, this is, will be hard. It's when she's coming forward here. I will do voleo, okay? But this voleo is not voleo that we know. We will just cross the knee and pivot. See? And the pivot itself, it makes the leg be crossing, okay? So if you practice this movement on your own, it's gonna be tuck, leave the knee there, don't do voleo, leave it in there, keep it like a pushing.
Imagine.
Like a pulling that direction.
Here.
And you will pivot.
Yeah.
And the cross it will appear by itself.
Yeah. So also the element that we are working also from the beginning with Enrosques is the quality in the pivot, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's not that we will do voleo and pivot, it's just very smooth movement, and the result will come if you do very nice pivot there.
And the contraposition of the knee. Let's say you are turning to the left, to the right, sorry, in this case, but your knee, it will remain in your left side. It's like a two opposite direction, circle. And my knees go there, remain there, let's say, and my pivot go that direction, okay? And also, when I do the pivot, it's gonna be at the moment that she pivot, she do the forward step, sorry, here. As she pivot here, in this forward step, I will pivot too. Eh? Let's do. I will pivot too. Eh? So this is the other one that you will find. And what else?
And the way to lead forward, forward.
Ah, okay. The forward, forward. Yes, so this is the way that you will break
the system.
The system of the lady. Let's say the system of the lady, it is forward. Side, backward, side, forward. It's a circle, it's a loop, a continuum forever and ever. Josefina will show you now.
Yeah,
forward, side.
Forward, side, backward, side, depending where you start, but you can start also side, forward, side, backward, and keep going, right? It's always one forward step, one backward step, and two side steps in between. This is the normal system of hero that we always work.
Mm-hmm. So we break that system. Let's say, for example, she as she went far backward. Sorry, as she went far backward. After she will do the side step. After will come forward step. Okay. After will come the side step. Exactly.
Now.
And again. Supposed to come a backward step, but instead we will send her again to another forward step. So this is the way that we will break the system. So let's review this.
Show you one more.
Yeah. So it's a forward.
Forward, side, backward, side, forward, side, no backward, forward.
Eh?
See?
And this is something that you, the leader, will lead her. But you're wondering how?
How?
It's impossible. So, if you pay attention after the backward step, after the forward side, and the backward step that is coming now, as she collect to prepare to go to backward, this shoulder blade is open. Although she doesn't want to do this action, do it.
Exaggerate.
It will happen because she tried to block the upper body and do just the dissociation from the low body. Do the dissociation, but see, the shoulder blade is
it's moving outside
by itself, so
yeah.
That's it, the secret weapon that we will use. We will interrupt the action of the shoulder blade
to open.
So she came forward, let's say, she goes side, I will stop the action, she tried to go backward. See? With my toes here, I'm blocking
fingers.
I'm blocking the fact for she to go. and after that I will push her forward. Mm? So with this hand, it's, you have a big power. So you will not allow her to go, but you will block, eh? In contraposition, and you will push her forward.
So as we are doing from the beginning, you practice by separate. Also, this action that Fabi is doing, the leader remain in the center, mm-hmm. and he just lead me forward, side.
I will.
Sí, yes, yes. Okay, thank you. Forward, side.
And she will try to go backward, but I will not let her go. Believe me, here Josefina is trying to go, eh? Look, try to go. I allow her to go. Try to go again. I block her. And send
forward.
Her
forward.
This is a very tricky moment because when the lady normally knows this sequence, she behaves like a forward, side forward by herself. It will not appear the mood that
or
we
forward,
have.
Forward, no?
Yeah. Forward, yeah, forward, forward, forward
yeah.
sometimes. And normally, our students, when we teach this, they do forward, forward, and forward. No.
The nice, should be the real, no?
The nice, yes, exactly. The nice part of this step is the fact that she will do this action. Ooh, that little twist, over contraposition twist in her body, it will give it to the
step
a very nice and beautiful mood, eh?
Yeah.
So let's show. Boom, boom, eh? Let's do it more exaggerated to the camera can see it. And boom. See how Josefina pretend to go? Boom, but I block her. This is super exaggerated, don't do
yeah,
this.
Yeah, yeah, it's exaggerated, but do you see that it's really, it's coming from a lead? That every single thing that is coming from a lead looks real. So this is what we always look, mm-hmm. look in tango. Even with the more complex things, we think that some things are prepared, but even the more complex things can have this kind of code between us, no?
Yes. Exactly, yes. This is how it is. So how you will practice this for separate? So practice embracing will help a lot. So you go, we show you in front of the camera. You will send her forward, so it doesn't matter what you do with the feet. So you will send her forward, she will try to go backward, and you will block her, eh? But please, ladies, don't
help.
Don't help. You do what you're supposed to do, which is go backward. So try to go backward and bring her forward. This is the way, eh? I'm using my two hands already, eh? Okay? Once you get this move and she got the idea, you will send the exercise to just one hand. Eh? So use only one hand. Two, boom, boom. Mm? It's gonna be a little bit hard, but this is how it's gonna be, it should be.
Yeah, and a way to improve also, when you practice, don't practice every time. Once you get the system, no? That you know how to lead, try to go for the normal hero, back, forward, side, backward. Let the lady go in a normal system of hero, and somehow when you want, you change the order. To also make, because for us, the lady, we need to start to learn how to be more sensitive, more open to every single change, no?
Shall we show them?
Yes. Okay,
vale. So you will just let her go in there. Once she gets used to the normal hero, you will find and you will follow the step of backward, side, backward, side, forward, side, woo-woo. Eh?
See?
You will get dizzy because the point is that we call this action in the practice way, we call marear a la compañera. Marear a la compañera is an expression that actually marear is means dizzy.
Yeah.
Make her dizzy.
Yeah.
Lose the
yeah.
the orientation, okay? And this is the action, but in this case, it's more like an expression, which it means let her go with the flow, let her go with the flow, to she don't realize that the lead that you are practicing are gonna appear.
Yeah.
She need to feel that the, okay, maybe we're gonna come now, no, now, maybe now, no, now. This is the fact.
Yeah, and it's really helpful for both also, because if I do by my own, I'm not helping the leader to really understand if the things are working, no? Mm-hmm.
So you probably might practice with another steps. Also, this is another, so you're practicing, I don't know. You're dancing, she doesn't know when I will do this, but she knows that I will practice this. Do you know that it will come?
No.
This is the fact, because she was concentrated on the movement. She knows it's going to burst somehow in some moment, but not exactly when.
Yeah, but it's a very good topic to practice between the couple, because it's also this is part of connection, no? It's about communication.
So more when you're practicing to do improvising.
Yeah, of course.
So, yeah. So what else we need for this?
Technical? The change of direction a bit.
Okay, the change of direction, this is going to be for both.
Yeah, for both, yeah.
So we will do just this exercise, probably you have seen.
I will do it in the side, no?
So, exactly.
Because I look better in the side
way. Sí, pero ahí vas a tener. Okay, well, no,
what is this action? Okay, dale.
No, así lo haces de frente. Cuando estás así, haces de frente. Y cuando estás así, lo haces de costado. Okay. Así lo haces de costado. Okay, we are having a change of the opinion. So I will show you from side, as you see me, but she wants to do from front. So how it is the action here? I will do it in the side way, she will do it in the front way. So what she might have, as I do it in front, encounters that her chest might show, might watch the front wall. In my case, my chest should watch
me.
That front. And what I will do, I will behave with my feet, in this line.
Going in this line. So we are like a cross, right? The chest is looking one front, but the hip and the leg working perpendicular line.
Let's take a little more space and we'll perpendicular in the camera. Let's say, yes. So, how will we do? I will watch there, she will watch the camera. I will go with the front foot, which is free, the right one in this case. And as the foot is it's going, the base foot is gonna pivot. And the chest remain.
The chest remain, and the leg remain also in the line that have started.
I will change by crossing.
Cross, the change the way, and we have again the front leg free. And when the front leg start to go in linear, the base leg start to pivot. Finish completely again with the hip looking the same front as before.
Change
weight.
And
forward. Really important, we are using very clear the lower dissociation, right?
Mm-hmm.
There is no tension in the upper body. And that's it.
And you will practice by helping yourself, by helping together. Like this, I will be the base, and Josefina will do the top again. And Josefina will do it. Good.
I will leave the torso with Fabi.
I'm not leading this because it's just an exercise to she. Eh?
It's an adorno that we can do in the pivot, right?
Exactly.
And then we change.
And I will do it. So my upper body is going to be facing to Josefina, to my partner. And
oh.
The low body. And it's good to lose weight
here
in this part. Okay.
Okay, I think we have all the elements, right?
To can show the figure and yes. To finish, right?
Yes, it is.
Perfect. So we will show you now the finish. But no, I don't want to miss this very nice salida.
Dale.
Which is this way. It's a double salida for the ladies. Boom. Boom, boom, boom.
And for you, you're not doing side step?
No.
Okay.
And this is the secret. So what I will do is you will think more like around or surrounded salida, side salida. So you will go backward, you will go side, and after all that you will do is open the left foot and close.
Oh, nice.
And that's it. And this action, also plus your lead, is gonna make the lady go around of you with another side salida. Mm?
So this is another part that you can use whenever you want.
So side salida.
Normal.
And change again to the left again to go out. It's very nice. And the feeling is nice too. So, let's show with the music a little less. So we show you now the fear. The music a little up. We will close the window to the neighbor. And that's the figure. Eh? So just to finish now, we will show you the structure. Eh? Very slowly and with the practice embrace, then you can see better, okay? As you see, I was mareando a Josefina. I don't want her to know when the figure is gonna come. This is gonna give you more realistic improvisation mood. So practice embrace. So we will start with the double salida.
This is what you learn at the end.
We go to the cross. We go to the sacada with the left.
Pivot americana.
Pivot down. She go power and go forward.
I go side.
I cross and change my way backward and pivot in my left. So we repeat the action. She go power, go forward.
Back, side.
I do sacada.
Forward. Keep turning.
And I go up with my hand. And I repeat again the action of she go back or go forward. And change the way. Now we will do this.
I can do also.
And sacada.
Sacada.
And rock. Lapis. Voleo. And when she comes forward, I pivot the loop. From voleo, the forward salida, side step of the lady, sacada, finish. A little pivot here to close the position, and 1, 2, 3 by bend, and 6, 7, and 8.
Perfecto.
Something else?
No.
You want to
see? Way around, it's okay.
Okay.
From the we start. Okay, one more with practice and raise.
Thank you. you so much. And this was the figure of tango, the figure from Nati and Capo Moyano. Both were the husband and wife, wife and husband. So that's why they call Nati and Carlos Moyano, or Carlos Moyano and Nati.
We hope you like it, we hope you enjoy it, and we hope you work with us, and see you in the next one. Welcome everybody.
So we are in Dias de Tango, we continue with the lesson, and now we pass to the part of Milonga.
Milonga.
Very nice. So as in the previous one, we will show you one figure, and we will develop some exercise of the element that you will use in this step or figure. But not only, you also will learn these technique exercises that you will improve for Milonga in general. So let's go for the step first. It's a very nice step. Transfer of the weight. Instead, when you behave with the toes, the axis, you behave faster. So that it will help you better for Milonga. So, but how we will use this action? Normally, when we go to the toes, our body go up. So we don't want that.
No, of course not.
We want to keep the same level. So here we will use element that we call knee to the chest or rodillas al pecho. So you will behave, let's say, soft knee at the beginning as normal. Right? And, oh, nice feet. Then you will remain and you will put in front of the mirror and you will remain in the same height and you will take no the chest as you bend, but the knee to your chest. Like you want to go here. Or here, but without to separate your toes from the feet. So remain the foot. This is the, let's say the.
Yeah, to don't go up with the chest. Just you see, the height of the chest is not changing. The only thing that is going is the heel go up and the knee want to go to the chest.
Mm-hmm. So you do a couple, and after you try to, I will do from side.
Yeah, I see.
And you will do. Just this action, and after you will do like a 1, 2, 3, and 4, and remain 1, 2, 3, and 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4.
I want to
at the end of the row, let me finish with this. At the end of the row, you will remain all the time here. You will not go down.
Something very interesting that Fabio is doing, and it's really important you do this, is that the shoulder need to stay aligned with the hip. You see, when you go up with the knee, it's not, maybe if he do wrong, he's going forward with the chest. Or he can compensate also going forward with the knee, with the hip. See, so the line between the shoulder and the hip needs to stay really perpendicular to the floor. See?
Okay, so this is a very simple exercise. When you get this, you will go for this exercise that now Josefina will show you something for that exercise. You will go front and backward and front and backward. I'm doing front with the right, backward with the right. After you change and you go front with the left, backward with the left. Let's say a million of times, infinite times. The more you do, better put inside of your body.
Yeah, something else about this tool that Fabi is giving to you, it's really important for both role to have the limit when you go to the metatarso, the toes.
Okay.
My director is saying that I'm wrong with the camera. The idea is for both role, don't tense inside the shoes, don't tend the toes, see? So first things that you will do, I will show you with this ball that for us are really helpful, is I'm here and I will go up and down and up and down. What these balls will give it to you is the idea that you will be really grounded in the floor at the moment that you go down with the heel or up. And we will try the same exercise that Fabi did, that was here. You will go forward, forward, backward, and backward. So you have some reference here, see? If you squeeze, this is wrong. You need to stay up. Tum, tum, come back, come back. And remain there. See?
In tango, let's say, just to make the difference, let me see. In tango, you will do, you will squeeze, definitely. You will do
yes.
Right here, and you will squeeze to uncharge the way to the ground. But
yes.
Tango gives you more time to behave with the heel. In this case, milonga will not give to you. So that's why it's important that you don't squeeze.
Don't squeeze. In milonga, we will try to remain here.
Yes, then, if you don't have a ball, you can use, I don't know, paper ball.
Yeah, a pair of socks also.
Yeah, something that
ball.
Is give to you the idea. And for making your sensibility better, it's better without shoes.
Yeah.
So if you're a leader, without shoes, and although your heels are flatter than the woman's heels, without shoes is the best. And if you are a lady, without the heels it's gonna be the most.
Yeah, it's really important to understand what happened inside the foot, the shoes, no, in tango. Because when we dance, our shoes are inside. So we need to learn how to use them first in contact with the floor to sustain our whole body, and then will be really, really easy once you put the shoes, right? So this for the idea of the heel up.
And if you want to practice something afterwards, you get this, you just do it yourself, you do the basic, normally, with the toes. Eh? If you play milonga, just walk in the toes. Just practice, eh? This to give to your toes the strength that you need. Eh? Now, for the elements that we will find in this figure, there is something that we call atrás adelante. Atrás adelante. It means backward, atrás, adelante, forward. Okay? So how we will think on that? We have two lines. Let's say.
We have many friends today.
We have two lines. There you are. Perfect. These imaginary lines are our reference. I will be in the middle of both. So there is a main line here. Let's say this is the auxiliary line, and there is a main line here. Okay? So, and we will go, let's say, with the foot and with the, in this case, the right, it's gonna remain
in the central one.
In the central, on the main line, okay? Instead, The leg in this case is going to cross forward and backward. Forward and backward. Eh? When we come back, now my leg is going to remain in the main line and the right is going to cross forward, remain, backward, remain, forward, remain, and backward, remain. Hmm?
Yeah, some other details there I will show you here in the back that I already showed you in the side is that the feet need to work always parallel between them. You will apply what Fabi said with the central line and forward and outward line. And we will add the idea that the feet are always parallel.
Between each other.
Between each other. Look, this is not parallel. So I need to make them go parallel. Here also parallel, parallel. Even if they don't work in the same line, they work parallel between them. See? Mm-hmm. This is the other topic for this moment.
And so this step is called atrás adelante or adelante atrás because we are crossing forward and backward. So that's the simple explanation. So forward and backward. Forward and backward. But actually, as we start backward normally in these steps, let's say we do backward salida, side salida, it's called backward and forward. Atrás, adelante, okay? And the leg as well too, atrás, adelante.
Yeah, We use the main, the same that Fabi did, and we go backward and forward, and backward and forward.
But you see how they, let's say, for you to have another reference, the foot or the leg that is open, that is doing the side step is the one that is remain
in the
main or middle line.
I show you like this with both main, no?
Okay, so you are in that line.
Yes, this is my main, for example.
But we will not step, or we... We can't. Now, but let's say this is going to be our front line, let's say. So we'll start, there you are. Yes. So, side and atrás y adelante. Atrás y adelante. And see how our bodies... Our bodies are getting closer and farther. Just move closer than the sticks.
Okay.
So now, just taking note that this...
I have my main in the line of my hip.
And these lines are the front line, let's say. Okay?
Exaggerate, so we have the main in the left, I have the main in the right.
Exactly. So let's go side.
And side, look.
We get far.
Central, close to the stick. Central, out. Close.
Okay?
See?
This is how it's going to be the step. And you will see after how it's working inside of the step. What do we have here, Josefina?
Sandals.
Sandals.
Yeah, no, it's okay. No, I think that for the technique it's okay.
The adaptadita.
Yes.
Okay. Another element you will use here is another element. You will use here is the arrastradita, empujadita. Empujadita means a little pushing. Because you
it's
will
like
push.
A bit like this. But small.
Yeah.
I didn't do that.
But you will not push from the upper body, and this is the, let's say, the secret weapon of this step. You will push from your legs. Okay?
Yes.
So, let's give us an exercise today to understand this action. We will be like a close but side one to the other. And we will go to the previous exercise, which is go to our toes. And here see how my let's come back normal.
Normal.
They are not touching.
Space. Space. And we are touching.
We are touching here. Muscle to muscle, okay? I'm trying to think, okay, probably we can go just backward and forward, okay?
See?
So we go, this is an exercise.
So we are touching already, see?
And just go.
Hands, we need to keep both of us touching.
all the time our legs are touching, even when we are traveling away. We show you from this side, this way. So they are in contact. And see how I'm pushing her leg. Eh? I'm pushing her.
Yeah, it's a work of both of us to keep really, really the contact. And for me,
how we get this?
How?
If you have this posture, let's say, and the embrace, which are more separate in the legs, you will never find a way to get in contact with the leg of your partner. So, let's say we need to move our center or contact point more to this side, to this part, to the pelvis, let's say. Eh? You see, our chests are not touching. Our hips are closed. Eh?
What I just want to say something from the previous exercise.
I would love you to say something.
Most of the time, when we think in tango, we think that the leading is coming only from the chest.
Exactly.
Most of the time, we are really focusing the front part. Somehow, we also include the hands, the back, everything. But we can say 90% of the stuff we lead. And we receive the information in the upper part of the body. And what is really magic for me that we discover with this kind of step is that you can really lead and follow with the whole body, right? Because here the leg is not only a tool to move in the space, it's also a way to lead. So for me, this tool that we are giving to you is super useful. We use a lot. And here we really can say that we are dancing, leading and follow with the whole body, right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
So not just with the embrace, but also with the...
The whole, no?
The whole body.
The whole body, with the breathing, but also we have a lot of power in the contact with the leg. We have a lot of information when we touch each other the legs, right?
So. This is going to be the empujadita. So the empujadita is going to be the pushing of the leg. Tup, I'm pushing, ripping, with my leg. But it will not be in this way, it's going to be in this way. I'm in contact with her and I push it through. And the other way around, the same.
So the exercise you will do is like this, I'm a little bit forward.
Like a sitting.
With my hip, yeah, this also can be a little bit sentada, no?
Mm-hmm.
I can stay forward with my hip and pushing. Tum, tum,
tum. No, she's pushing me. Eh? So, this is the exercise that you will try to do before to do this.
So, I think it's time to go to the figure.
Let's go for the figure.
Yeah.
Okay.
You already have the most of the technique.
We will show you with the practice embrace first. So, you will start with the backward and double salido. This one, I'm more here. Exactly. Because the atrás y adelante is going to make a circle. Eh? From your left, from your right to your left, sorry. So, two. A double salido. You're in the midline and you will go atrás y adelante. At the moment that you're adelante, you will find that the feet are going to touch between each other, but it's going to be more this action, but you will see with embrace better. And let's do it again. So, backward, double salida, and both atrás and
mainline.
Adelante. Side, and
back, main,
adelante.
Oh.
Side and back,
the main and the forward.
Side and across,
the main forward.
See how we separate and we.
And we go close, it's like elastic, right? But not because we are looking from the upper part of the body, it's because we are really doing what we've been showing you with the lines.
Mm-hmm. So you will do two or three of these until I will do just two. So. Backward and side, double and backward and forward, side, backward and forward, side, and in here. As your feet are in contact, you will go both of you backward and backward.
And since my hip is inside, I will be the one who remain forward. See?
So you get the position of the contact of the legs of the to do the empujadita. You will do two of them, like a and empujadita. One and two. Eh? So you are right here and one and two. Or you can count 1, 2, 3. Not so good. Okay. Yeah. 1, 2, and 3. After you arrive here, you will center around.
Side step for me.
You will collect and chin the way.
And I go backward, and again we are in the same position, but in the other way around.
And she go backward with the
right.
And I go backward with the left. And again you will do empujadita with the right now. 1 and 2. After that, let's continue. After that, you did already 1 and 2. Let's do it. 1 and 2. You will face into her.
I go.
And at the moment that you're facing, you lift her and you will go
side
2 times. And you are ready to finish. Let's do it. Let's do it with the other front. So, back one. It is with the embrace. This is something that we use a lot and it's so useful. When we embrace, so we say we try to be close with the hips and separate with the chest. So you will think that you trap between your chest, both chest, let's say a tea table, the small one, in between. Both of you will not, or will try to don't let the table.
Became crooked.
And you will try to keep this imaginary table, tea table, flat, parallel to the floor all the time. So
we are here. Look, if I'm here, the tea table is not working.
So here, all the time here. And this is the posture that you will use. More close with the lower part of the body. And more separate is going to give it to you in the upper body, it's going to give it to you also a faster reaction in the milonga. Okay? So, shall we show them?
With the music?
With the music.
Okay.
Ahora
que milonga nos quedó acá.
Tango Home Edition or Online Edition.
Joven Final Models.
And this is Fabian Peralta.
Just in case, if you get lost.
So we will work today on the balls. We will work in the balls.
And we will use somehow the same system that we work in tango and in the milonga. We will show you the figure that we will work. But then we will start working and developing some technical tools that will be useful, as we said, not only for this step, it's just to grow in your tango, and then we will see how we apply this technique in the final step, we hope.
We will find also some elements for separate and we will improve in this, figure. One thing I want to say is that, can you play music?
Yes, I will do, and I will play bass.
Until Josefina found the music, I will say that what a milonga, tango or vals, let's say the technique are quite similar for every rhythm, let's say. For example, we have learned the milonga that you can work with the toes and so on, but let's say that you have a rienzo and you want to do some very fast movement or step, then you also can use this action of the toes. Or with the bass also, you will have a different rhythm, but still, the technique is gonna work for tango, and the tango technique it will work for the bass and like that. So at the end of the row, we have two bodies working, synchronized at the same moment, embraced, and so on. So the options are all the same for anyone, every time. Yes, let's go for the bass. Let's show the figure. He had a very nice sense of humor. He was always making jokes and so on. So if you have the fortune to know him, probably you will remind him as a great person and funny guy to spend time with.
It's really nice to have these memories, right? Not only as a dancer, but also as a person. Yeah. I didn't meet him in person, but it's really nice to listen to you saying this.
Yeah, it's very nice to remember every time, because at the end of the row we are person, we are people behind what we do. Okay, so in these days that we cannot meet each other, it's nice to remember the persons who was part of the history of tango.
Yes, emotional moment.
Yeah. So, let's go for what we have in the list.
Yeah,
go for the technique now.
We can work in the triangle lines, in the catapulta, and we will work also in the kicks.
Okay. I will show you one exercise for the guys that will be used in this. We'll go for the triangle line. So, as in the milonga, we work on. It's okay, the music.
See?
We will think that we have two lines. In the milonga, we have two lines in front and backward, and we have one main line. In this case, we will have just two lines.
Do you need the six?
No, I will show you. I will show the list. So, and we will do a zigzag with the hip parallel to this line. So we will go with the left, crossing forward, collect with the right, going backward. So imagine that you are drawing a zigzag in the floor, eh? My hip is going to be all the time in front of the camera or the wall that you're watching, and you will cross in diagonal.
Forward.
Collect.
Back.
And open in diagonal to the backward line. Collect. Forward and back.
Also for the followers, eh?
Mm-hmm. Forward and back. Let's go to the other way around.
Yes.
Now we will cross the right and
go to the forward line, arrive to the axis, backward line in the line of the shoulder, cross, come back, always with the feet parallel and the hip is looking always at the same front, right?
Yeah, this is one way. Now, let's say that we want to do, we want to go into the balance rhythm. In this case, we will not cross. Going to the right, which this is one what is gonna occur in the step. We will not cross the left, which is the most natural way to go, but we will go with the right. But also the right is gonna go backward. So previously we said left and right, left and right. And now it's gonna be the diagonal front is gonna be by the right, and the diagonal backward is gonna be by the right too. So we need to add a double beat in between. So it's gonna be one and it's a weight change. One pam 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 pam. Okay, and you will take with the pass like one, two, three, okay? And one. So we will do this for the step. One, two, three, and one. Okay. This is what you will do exactly in the feet, okay? So it's a combination of this action with this action, okay? So it's a weight change to do one, two, three, and now you will do and one, just without to wait, without to change the weight. And this is gonna be the step that you will use in this case, okay?
And in this moment, just to show the two parts, the ladies will do only one and two, and that's it.
Exactly.
Do you have in mind the same?
Or if you want to count with the men, because you are doing together, you will count one, two, and one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. So you step in the one, just, and then two and three is going to be part of the men, no? Shall we do together this action?
Okay.
Okay. So, with the brace, we will do just exactly what we will do in this step. Eh? So, one, two, three, and again. One, two, three, and one. Ah, there you are. I'm sorry, my bad. And I can't even do it. Okay. One, two, and three, and one. And this is gonna be the action, eh?
The only thing that was confused was the numbers, no?
The numbers.
The choreo was good.
Yeah, so we could edit this part to don't show that the teacher was doing wrong, but it's also part of the life. We also make mistakes. We also, like, we are not super gods, or we think we never get to make a mistake, but we do, exactly, and this is the fact. In that case, what was happened to you, understand? Josefina was using one beat and I was using another one, or speed, let's say. I was going slower than her and she went faster than my step. So that's why it wasn't match. But let's show you again. One, two, three, and one, okay? With the lead of the hand, you will send her, and this is the difficult part, you will send the beat and beat. One and one. This is the action with the hand that you will need. But instead of your leg, you're going to do a different speed or a different time, yeah? Timing. Yeah? Let's see that part. What else we have?
It's important to draw the triangle first.
Mm-hmm.
See, when we both of us will go backward.
Okay. Yes.
We will have, so, yes.
For me, it's gonna be Josefina. We do from five, hace como de espaldas, from the espaldas de atrás, desde el costado, ahí y anda atrás el triángulo. In my case, I will be front, and we will do together but separately. Okay, so and
I will be both.
Yes, collect and pivot, and I will change and See? We will try to find this triangle.
So again, we start the exercises. I start in the side step. I will pivot on my left and we go
and
together. Mm. And the important thing here is we need to create a triangle between our legs. See?
Mm-hmm. Once you get this, you will do together the practicing rest is side.
Same.
You're doing the sacada and you will do change okay. And go.
Triangle.
Mm-hmm. The separate one to show.
Exaggerate. The backward leg want to touch and the front leg have more space and the feet are all of them parallel.
Mm-hmm. And now here, another technique part is, let me show okay. Myself.
Yes.
So for the men, you will do without to transfer the weight to your heels. You will cross your right front leg to behind. Boom. And after you will put the heel in the floor. But first.
So at the beginning is like if you have a ball, right?
Okay. Whoop. Boom.
Mm. The exercise will be in longer.
Yeah, exactly. So I will go to my toes. And once I put my toes backward, I land with the heel. You please don't do this action to trample the weight, otherwise your weight trample is going to be so fast that you will be in jeopardy with your partner, because something that we will do now is the sentadita. How we do the sentadita?
So we are in the triangle.
I will lift her.
And go up.
And bring her to
and me. Just sit like crossing the knee. And come back.
Mm. Once
so
again.
Try by separate, put the very nice triangle here.
And
you lift me, I sit and come back. See?
See.
Sí. For the ladies, here, when he lifts you, you're in the axis. And then the sitting, without to stay with him, is like the knee need to look like when you go to go toilet, it's like this. Careful with the knees open, see? Don't be exaggerated, you shouldn't be like touching each other, but both of them want to go in. And actually we'll be like in a double pit, so it's not very big pose that you will stay there. So we'll be and one. So it's just a detail, the sentadita.
Exactly. So let's go for the another part.
Sí.
The other moment that you will find in this segment is the kick and voleo. And you will do, as a leader, you will think first in a neutral way. So
also for the followers.
In a leader way, I said, and after I will say for the followers, okay. In the backward way. But my point is what I want to show the leaders first and after to show the follower ways. Okay? So we go forward ocho, and as you do forward and transfer the weight, you will do the kick and voleo before to go to the next forward ocho. After you arrive to the forward ocho and you finish it, you will transfer the weight and do again kick and voleo before to go. So there is a kick and voleo before to go. Kick, voleo before to go. Kick, voleo before to go. And one thing that you need to take in account is that the kicking voleo is going to be opposite to the front that you are going. Let's say I go to this diagonal. My kick is going to be in that diagonal. Boom. And I follow this diagonal. Now my next kick with my left is going to be to the other diagonal. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. And as a follower, you will think in the backward ocho way. Okay? So
and I'm going to go in the backward way. Backward, 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 and backward. First, practice for a while only this action in the backward way, and then we will do kick, backward, voleo, kick, backward step. So we are voleo, kick, and we back to the base, which is the backward step. Instead of do ocho, we do adorno, adorno, backward ocho. Adorno, adorno, backward ocho. Voleo, kick, pivot. Look, It's bolero kick without pivot. And then I do the pivot to go for the 8. Bolero kick 8. I show you in the front. We go vanguard, patada, kick, voleo, no, kick, 8. Voleo, kick, 8. Voleo, kick, 8. Voleo, kick, 8.
So let's say that it's opposite, not just the 8 direction, I go forward, she go backward. But also the order of the adornment. The adornment in this case is going to be the voleo and the kick. So the lady is going to do first the kick, first the voleo and after the kick. And the leader is going to do first the kick and after voleo. Mm? So let's do it for separate. Hacelo, vamos a hacer el detallado para adelante o hacer para atrás. Momento.
Venimos de este lado.
Ahí está.
I start with a kick.
Sí. I start with the forward 8.
Y.
Kick. Voleo.
Voleo. Kick.
Boom. Kick.
Voleo. Kick. Voleo. Kick.
And see how we are. Match the voleo. Tam. Boom. Boom. Pam. Boom. Boom. You see, as we do, this is magic. As we do, I don't know how to say, diferido, siempre me sale. And in the first moment, at the end of the row, the voleo of both match at the same moment. Eh? So, this is the other element that we will use. What else we have? The catapulta.
Yes.
Mm? Well. Vamos a explicar la catapulta. La catapulta, I think in English is called catapulta too.
I don't know.
But the catapulta, it was a machine that people in the wars like 5 centuries ago, they used to drop a big rock. Eh? It was this big machine made by wood that is have a spin and so on, or a weight here, so they put a rock. Here at the end we do, and the rock is go, let's say a rock dropping, a rock dropper. Eh? So and this is catapulta, and it's called catapulta because we're actually pushing the lady to the next step. Okay, normally we do this action with this step. Bam, bam, bimba, boom, boom. Together to go this. I don't know if you as you're watching your advanced or professional, but you will see that this element or this way to get into the right hero, it's hero to the right, is well known. But we, Pupi Castello, use it in different ways. So normally we trample the way together, you see the difference? We trample the way together, see? Side step, I wait, one step, and go. Okay? Once again, trample the way together, boom. I trample with her when she trample, when she go forward, and I go. In the catapult, I will be delayed with respect to her. So, what I will do is sending her to do most quantity of steps that have this movement, let's say. Wait, and say ta 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 ta, and I will catch at the end this movement. So I'm delayed like a 2 or 3 steps, no? Jose?
Let me show you this way. That we are crossing like this, no?
Si.
And another detail that to kind of arrive to this move, it's the beginning of the step, the side step. Here is like bending, and actually we are going very long projection to then kind of arrive to this move. See? Mm-hmm.
So let's say I arrive to the first weight change of her. And take you back from here. finger is sending. Send the finger. See? She are right there. And I go like a pop back at the end. And like a double beat to catch her. It's a very nice way to get in. It is called catapulta. For Pupi Castel, it was so easy, I guess, because he have a big belly, so it could be the gravity center was so behind, so he could go very, very, very backward and sending all his weight to the to the backward leg and wait, project and go. Nada más, creo, ¿no? Ya está. Okay, there is no press other than show you the figures, okay? So we do the practicing race. Catapulta, boom, boom, bam, boom. Here we will do a double beat. Double beat. And we will arrive to the triangle we have said. And we will do the sentadilla, okay? Vamos a hacerlo con el frente, así entramos mejor. Catapulta, tap, tap, double beat, and sentadita, okay? Perfecto. Once you are right there, we'll show you this part. You do sentadita, tiki tiki tiki, vamos a ver, doo-doo-doo. You will go with the 1, 2, 3 zigzag. 1, 2, 3, 1. It's gonna be the sacada. Boom, boom. So once you do 1, 2, 3, 1, boom, you will need pago voleo and kick. And here you will get into the system of kick, voleo, kick. Kick, voleo, kick. Kick man, voleo, kick woman. Kick man, voleo, kick woman. And something that we didn't show you, that you will do all, you can do in the line, this kick sequence, as we did. But it's nicer if you, the leader, draw in your mind an imaginary circle for ocho. Eh? This action. So, ocho, kick, voleo, boom. Kick, voleo, boom. See, I'm drawing a circle that I'm following, and you will adjust the ocho of the lady in order to follow that circle. And that's gonna give it to you a nice bow tie, a bow to the present of which is this very beautiful figure. So, what else? Shall we show it with the music?
Yeah, let's go for the full.
See? Okay. We will do it a few times. Say La Leona,
Graciela
González used to be his partner. but he danced with many different ladies. So if you have the chance to watch him, there is some videos on YouTube, you will see this step and many others that are very nice. So, from our part, thank you so much
for accompanying us.
Dziękuję bardzo. Bardzo dziękuję. To accompany us in these beautiful lessons. We feel nearby to you guys, at least by this method, which is the online or home edition videos. Keep practicing.
And see you and stay. See you very soon. We hope we can hug each other in the next festival, because for us the festival Días de Tango it's in our heart. So thank you so much for inviting us one more time. And dziękuję bardzo. Gracias.
Oof. 26, 24.